Hello there! On today's video, I'm going to show you how to edit my personalized digital planner in the Mac Keynote app. When you purchase a digital planner, you will get this download window. Click on the download button and save the planner on your computer. Double-click on the zip file to view its content. Inside the file, you will find a Keynote folder and a PDF folder. The PDF file is ready to be used in the GoodNotes app or any other planning app. Simply import it and start planning. Inside the Keynote folder, double-click on the instructions manual. Before we start editing the digital planner in Keynote, you need to install the fonts I use on the planner. The fonts are free and you may download them by clicking on the links I included in the instructions manual. Save the fonts inside the Keynote folder so that you can easily find them in one place. To install the fonts, double-click on the zip folders and install the font that ends in OTF. When you install the font, the computer automatically opens the fonts window to show you the font that was installed. Sometimes you have to manually search for the name of the font to double-check that it was installed on your computer. After all the fonts have been installed, double-click on the Keynote Planner. The planner file is big, with about 630 slides. Please wait as it loads on your computer. This is how the planner will look like when you open it in Keynote. On the left side of the app, you will notice the months have been neatly stuck together. You can click on the arrow and the slides for that month will be shown. This planner is for the current calendar year and gets updated every year. The planner includes future log, cover page, monthly calendars, weekly spreads, habit tracker, meal tracker, mood tracker, saving tracker, and spending trackers. The planner also includes extra dot, blank, graph, and line pages on each month for you to create your own layouts. The mood tracker for each month has a different coloring theme, and you can delete the trackers or change them to other shapes. Let's say you want to track your pain instead of your mood. On your keyboard, press the keys Command and F, or go to the top left toolbar, choose Edit, click Find, and click Find again. A small box will appear on the screen. On the top, type the word mood. Underneath, type the word pain. Click Replace All. Now all the words in the Keynote file will be changed to pain. Let's change the word mood in the tabs. On the right side of the toolbox, click on Edit Master Slide. On your keyboard, select the keys Command and F. On the little pop-up box, type the word mood in the top and the word pain underneath. Select Replace All. Now all of the words in the tabs have been changed from mood to pain. At the bottom right of the screen, click Done to exit the Master Slide window. Now go to the main index of the planner. You may notice that the word mood did not change in the index. Unfortunately, I don't know why the index is the only place where the words won't change. An easy way to solve this is by using the Find tool. On your keyboard, press the keys Command and F. On the pop-up window, click on the top box that says mood. You will see the word mood highlighted in yellow. Double-click on the word mood tracker and replace the word with pain tracker. Click on the right arrow from the pop-up box. Select the word mood tracker from the next slide. Change the word from mood to pain by clicking on the highlighted text. Repeat these steps with all of the remaining months. You will know all the words have been changed when the arrow in the pop-up box does not find any more words that start with mood. To change a font on the planner, select the font that you want to change by clicking on the word. On the toolbar of the right, you can see the name of the font. On the top of the screen, select Format and then click Replace Fonts. A pop-up window with all the fonts will appear. Find the name of the font that you want to change. On the right, select the new font that you want to use and click the Replace Fonts button. You may notice one of the fonts overlap with the weekly spread box. With your mouse, drag down the word. If you go through the pages of the planner, you will see that all the fonts have been changed to the new one. The weekly spreads come in two versions, horizontal and vertical. The vertical version is perfect if you prefer to use time blocks to manage your daily to-dos. You can change all the layouts on this planner, delete one item or everything on the page to create your own layouts. For example, let's delete this weekly spread and create a new one. As you can see, I play around with different shapes and ideas. I use my keyboard shortcuts, Command C to copy, Command V to paste, and to select different items on the screen, I hold down the Command key and select several items on the screen. I always add things to my spreads and then delete them. Don't be afraid to play with shapes and fonts. My best advice is to try to recreate a layout from Instagram or Pinterest to get familiar with the Keynote tools. To change the cover of the planner, select the first slide from the left. On the right toolbar, click on the colorful ball. Select the color that you want for your planner. You can also choose a color gradient or an image by choosing the options from the drop-down menu. To change the cover of the planner to an image, select the Image Fill option from the right toolbox. You will see a temporary gray image. On the right, select the Choose button to find an image for your planner. On the right toolbox, I like to keep the scale of the image as a scale to fit. To set the cover on all the slides, in the top left, right-click on the first slide. Choose the option Select All, right-click on the slide again and choose the Expand option. Right-click on the slide one more time and choose the Select All. This ensures that the slides that are hidden will also get the new cover. Now, go to the toolbar on the right. If you're filling the planner with an image, select the Image Fill option. If you choose a color, select the Color Fill. Wait a couple of seconds for the cover to be changed on all the slides. Now, go through the slides to see the new cover of the planner. You can also change the cover of the planner for only 1 month and leave a different cover for the rest of the planner. To do this, go to the cover page of the specific month. I'm going to use January for this example. If the slides are hidden, right-click on the small slide on the left and choose Expand. On your keyboard, hold down the Shift key and look for the last slide of the month. Click on the last slide while holding down the Shift key. Go to the right toolbar and select a color or image that's specific for that month. To change the color of the tabs, click on the Edit Master Slide option located on the right toolbar. On the Master Slide screen, click on the January tab that is located in the top right of the planner. On the right toolbox, choose a color for the tabs. If you want the same color for several tabs, in the color wheel, drag and drop the color to one of the empty squares. Go to the next slide, click on the tabs, and click on the color you put in the small square. Always make sure to select the tabs first and then the color. Depending on how you want the planner to look, you can have all tabs in one color or have different colors on each tab. Once you're done, click the Done option in the bottom right of the screen. Okay, here's an overview of how the planner looks after we change the cover for the whole planner and for one specific month. Once you're happy with the planner, it's time to export it. In the top left of the screen, select File, Export To, and PDF. Select Image Quality as Best, click the Next button, and wait a couple of seconds to get a window to save your planner. Save the planner to a cloud folder like Dropbox, OneDrive, or iCloud. You need to have access to that cloud folder on your iPad. Now, open your favorite planning app. On this video, we're going to add the planner to GoodNotes. On the left of the screen, click Import to find the planner. You can see all the cloud locations by clicking the Browse button at the bottom.
Another way to import the planner is by gently dragging the files up to the right side of the screen. Then, gently press on the planner and drag and drop it into the GoodNotes app. This is how the planner looks after we edit it in the Keynote app.